Should I update to Windows 11? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Ask Leo is sponsored in large part by the patrons of Ask Leo. Visit askleo.com/patron to find out how you can become a patron, support Ask Leo, and get access to patron exclusive content. So, Windows 11 was announced some weeks ago to much fanfare, a lot of press, of course, and a lot of confusion. As a result, I am getting the question, okay, great, Windows 11, should I update? Normally, the answer is it depends. It depends on a lot of different things. In this case, the answer is actually really, really clear. No. No, you should not update to Windows 11. There's a variety of reasons, but the biggest reason for most people is very, very simple. It's been announced, and there are test versions of it around, but it hasn't been released. It is not done. In fact, it's a long way from being done. It is not ready for the general public, and no, you should not update to it for no other reason than that, right? It's just not something that's ready for the general public. It's not ready for you. Now, if you need initial reasons, I've got them. One of the things that has caused a lot of confusion with Windows 11 from the get-go are its requirements. It apparently has new hardware requirements. My theory, of course, is that's one of the reasons they went for the name change, so that they could more easily change the fundamental requirements for the operating system. But the problem, of course, is that the operating system requirements have already changed a time or two. I'm not convinced that the requirements that are in place today are going to persist until Windows 11 is actually released. And to be clear, as I record this in the middle of July, Windows 11 will not be released for the general public for at least another 6 months. We're looking at early next year at best. So there's a lot of opportunity for things to change, and I think that one of the places things will change is, in fact, in its minimum hardware requirements. We'll see how it shakes out. The other thing, this one is kind of weird. It's not a reason. I don't want it to be a reason. It's kind of like a curse. It's the every other version theory of Windows. If you go back to Windows XP, it was popular. The next version of Windows, Windows Vista, well, not so much. Windows 7, very popular. In fact, there are many, many adherents to it today. Windows 8/8.1, again, not so much. Windows 10, the most installed operating system on the planet ever. Many, many people swear by it. So, the next one in the sequence, Windows 11, would be in that not so much category. We might be wanting to wait for Windows 12 before we really make any commitment to it. Again, there's really nothing factual about that analysis. I just find it kind of cute that on the every other version scale, which has held for a good 6 or 7 versions of Microsoft Windows, Windows 11 would be one to avoid. Now, I do want to point out that honestly, there's no compelling reason to move to Windows 11 right now or potentially even later. I'm not seeing anything that really has me super excited about Windows 11. What I recommend you do is you continue to use Windows 10, which will be supported for years to come, even after Windows 11 is released. Continue to use Windows 10, continue to get your work done, continue to keep Windows 10 as up-to-date as possible, and then, a year or two from now, when you get a new machine, or when something shows up that's really compelling about Windows 11, make the decision then. But today, July of 2021, no, there is no reason to even consider moving to Windows 11, because it ain't done. Hope that was helpful. I hope you find some interesting information out of that. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/135037. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.